केशव कृष्ण केशव कृष्ण केशव पाहि मम राम राघव राम राघव रक्ष मम
कृष्ण केशव कृष्ण केशव पाहि मम राम राघव राम राघव रक्ष मम
कृष्ण 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 पाहि मम राम राघव राम राघव रक्ष मम
कृष्ण केशव कृष्ण केशव पाहि मम राम राघव राघव रक्ष मम
कृष्ण 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 पाहि मम राम राघव राम राघव रक्ष मम
कृष्ण 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 पाहि मम राम राघव राम राघव राम राघव रक्ष मम
कृष्ण 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 पाहि मम राम राघव राम राघव रक्ष मम
manifests in many different ways is basically three ways and one of the ways he appears in the body of his devotees is known as avesh you know avesh so one day lord gauranga appeared in the body of nakula brahmachari he entered into his body and nakula brahmachari's body became effulgent like 10,000 suns and thousands of people from bengal they started coming to see nakula brahmachari And Swami, he actually revealed the Gaur Gopal mantra to this world. And in Chaitanya Charitamrita, when Nakula Brahmachari's body became full with Avesh, at that time thousands and millions of people came to have his darshan. And one of the great associates of Gauranga, whose name was Shivananda Sen, he is the father of three sons, Kavi Karnapur. Including Kavi Karnapur. So he is one of the gopis in Radha Krishna Leela. His name is Viraduti Gopi. Viraduti Gopi means he carries messages from between Radha and Krishna to facilitate their milan of Radha and Krishna, to union. So he very advanced Vaishnava. He was the one who leads all the devotees from Bengal to Puri 4 months in the year. All devotees come to meet Gauranga in Gambira. So he is the one who used to make all the arrangements. He even used to make arrangements for Nityananda Prabhu. So very advanced. And by his order and inspiration only Kavi Karnapur, it was revealed in his heart who the devotees in Krishna Leela, who they are in the Gaur Leela, you know, their identities. That was revealed to Kavi Karnapur by the blessings of his father, Shivananda Sen. He writes in the starting of the book, and Gaur Ganodesh Deepika. He wrote a book, Gaur Ganodesh Deepika, how the, who are the Gaur Parshadas in Krishna Leela. So, Shivananda Sen also inspired and taught Kavi Karnapur the famous Chaitanya Sahasranam, 1000 names of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That also is by the mercy of Shivananda Sen. I mean, his glories are unlimited. When Shivananda Sen used to bear a child, Lord Gauranga would become very happy. He would say that your child, he will get love. He was so dear. In fact, his son Paramananda, that is Kavi Karnapur Puridas, he was so dear to Gauranga that when Shivananda Sen bought him, Gauranga put his toe, you know, of his foot in the mouth of the son when he was very small, put the toe in the mouth, and then he became a big, all the leelas appeared in his heart because of that mercy. So Shivananda Sen was very, very dear to Lord Gauranga, and Shivananda Sen came to that place, and from far he saw that thousands of people are gathered around Nakula Brahmachari. You know, he has got avesh. But Shivananda Sen said, I will not accept so easily that Gauranga has come in his body. I need some proof. So he thought in his mind that um, if Nakula Brahmachari can tell the mantra which I am chanting in my heart constantly, if he can tell me what mantra I am chanting, because Gauranga is Sarvagya, he is omniscient, he will know everything. So if Gauranga has appeared in his body, then he should be able to tell me what mantra I am chanting. So then I will I will be convinced that Gauranga has appeared. So, and he has not told anyone. In fact, nobody in the world knew that word mantra he used, except the Lord. It was Ishta mantra. In the verse it is said, Apana bolana more iha yodi jani amara Ishta mantra jani kohe na apani. So, if Apana bolana more, if he tells on his own what mantra I am chanting, I will even not even ask him. If he tells on his own what mantra I am chanting, then I will understand. Amara Ishta mantra jani kahe na apni. If he tells me what is my Ishta mantra, my most worshipable mantra, then I will understand that he is Abesh, Gaura Abesh. So when he was thinking like that, a big chamatkar happened. Nakula Brahmachari, he started shouting, where is Shivananda Sen? Where is Shivananda Sen? Thousands of people were gathered around him. He said, Shivananda Sen, you come here, you come here. But he was very back, he could not hear. So he called his servants. Nakula, he said, you bring Shivananda Sen here. So, and he said, what do you do? He did pranam. And then Nakula Brahmachari spoke this famous verse here. This Chaitanya Charitamrita Anti Leela 2.31. गौर गोपाल मंत्र तुमार चारी अक्षर अविश्वास छाड़त गई करियाचि अंतर. गोपाल मंत्र कंपोज ऑफ फोर सिलेबल्स विच इज योर इष्ट मंत्र, इट इज वर्शिपेबल मंत्र. नाउ प्लीज अब गिव अप द डाउट्स दैट हैव रिसाइडेड विद इन योर हार्ट अबाउट द आवेश ऑफ गौरांग विद इन मी. So he mentions that you are chanting the four akshar, char akshar ka Gaur Gopal mantra you are chanting. But which is that mantra, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami did not reveal in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. What is that four syllable Gaur Gopal mantra? And the great Acharya who revealed this mantra to this world, is the most merciful Acharya of the modern times, and who has actually delivered the whole world by revealing this Charakshara mantra in Kali Yuga, which is our most dear Shiksha Gurudev, Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur. He is the Acharya who could actually, who can see the pastimes in his heart which are happening. And he wrote the commentary to this verse, Chaitanya Charitamrita. And he said that Gaura, down it is, Gaura Gopala Mantra Gauravadi Gana Gauranga Name Chaturakshara Gaura Mantra Ke Uddesh Kure. That this four syllable Gaura Gopala Mantra is actually Gauranga Gauranga Gauranga. This Gauranga's name itself is the Charakshara mantra. And he writes that Keval Krishna Vadi Gana Gauru Gopal Mantra Shabdi Radha Krishna Chaturakshara Mantra Ke Uddesh Kore. So those who are worshippers of only Radha Krishna, they understand Radha Krishna as the Chaturakshara Mantra. But those who are followers of Gauranga and Radha Krishna both, like us, the Gaudiyas, we accept Gaura and Anga.
Gauranga.
The Chaturakshara Gaura Gopal. It's only four syllables, but every syllable is full of sweetness, because it is a combined form of Radha and Krishna. And Shivananda Sen, because he was a Rasika devotee, he was not an ordinary, he is Radha Krishna Gopi. Because he was a Rasika devotee, he was chanting the Gauranga mantra. Actually, Gauranga mantra can give us Madhurya, can give us Radha Krishna's Prem in Vraja. That is confirmed by Narad Muni in Avadhuta Mahatmya. He says, Gaura Nama Je Labe Vraja Vasa Gaura Nama
जेई लबे कृष्ण कृपा तारो हबे व्रजे वास्यै त पाइबे।
Whoever chanting Gauranga mantra, he will get Krishna kripa very quickly, and he will get vasa vrindavan, actual vasa in the eternal abode. So Prabhupada, our AC Bhakti Vedanta Srila Prabhupada, he wrote the commentary to this verse, and he made it even more clear, the commentary of Bhakti Vinod Thakur, and he says that Bhakti Vinod, in the top, you know, Bhakti Vinod Thakur explains the Gaur Gopal mantra in the Amrit Pravaha Bhashya. Worshippers of Sri Gaur Sundar accept the four syllables of Gaura, Ang, A and Anga as the Gaura mantra. But worshippers of Radha Krishna accept the four syllables of Radha Krishna as the Gaur Gopal mantra. But it's saying, however, Vaishnavas consider Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to be non-different than Radha Krishna, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Radha Krishna. Therefore, one who chants the mantra Gauranga and one who chants the name of Radha Krishna are on the same level. This is Prabhupada's direct words. It is not in any letters or any conversations. It is directly in the book Chaitanya Charitamrita, which are the law books. And Prabhupada said, everything I have given in my books. So he has said that this mantra Gauranga and mantra, anybody who chants Gauranga mantra and anybody who chants Hare Krishna on the same level, because there is no difference between Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Radha Krishna. So that is why we see when Nityananda Prabhu was sent to Bengal by Gaur Hari to preach Harinam, he did not preach Harinam in the beginning. He says, Bhaja Gauranga, Kaha Gauranga, Laha Gaurangir Namare, Je Jana Gauranga Bhaje, Shehai Mora Pranare. You know, he said, you chant Bhaja Gauranga, Kaha Gauranga. You know, he's saying, take the name of Gauranga and Laha Gaurangir Namare. He's taking two times, he's saying. And in that way, if somebody worships Gauranga, then he is my life and soul. So, actually, the mantra which Nityananda Prabhu is preaching is actually the Gaur Gopal mantra, Gauranga. It is Namatmaka mantra, just like Harinam is Nam also and mantra also. Whereas Gayatri mantra and Klim mantras are not, they are not to be chanted by everyone, but Namatmaka mantras can be chanted by everyone. So, Harinam and Mahamantra, similarly Gauranam and Gauranga Mantra, they are the same. And Gauranga Mantra is also known as Gauranam. So, it is for everyone, as per the instructions of Bhakti Vinod Thakur. In fact, Gauranga Mantra is chanted in Goloka Dham also. You know that next, if you can see, Pay 2, in Chaitanya Mangal Sutra Khanda, Lochandas Thakur explains that Hema Gaura Kalevara Mantra Charya Akshara Vai Sahaja Vai Kunda Natha Shyam. He says that the Lord sits on a beautiful throne and everybody's his complexion is brilliant like molten gold, and he is being bathed, abhishek, by the chanting of the Gauranga Mantra. Mantra Char Akshara. In Chaitanya Mangal also it is said that the mantra for Gauranga is Charakshara mantra. Gauranga, Gauranga. He is bathing there. He is worshipping. One side is Radha, Chandravali and all the gopis, and other side Rukmini, Satyabhama and all the queens. They are putting Abhishek on Gauranga's form. Narada Muni handles Darshan in Chaitanya Mangal. And they are all chanting, even Radharani is chanting Gauranga mantra. Gauranga, Gauranga. When in Vilapa Kusumanjali it is described, Swapna Vilasamritam, it is described that Radha and Krishna were sleeping in the Nikunja and Krishna was rubbing his Kaustubha Mani, and then Radharani saw in the Kaustubha Mani, Radharani saw the Ganga, you know, Ganga Devi, and on the banks of Ganga one very beautiful young man was dancing, and that young man was golden in color and he had curly hair and bimba lips. And you know, long eyes, his hands were going up to his feet, and his complexion was just like Radha, golden.
So Radha Rani became confused. He said, I do not get attracted to anyone except Krishna. But I am getting attracted to this. Who is this person? He is like Cupid. So she asked Krishna, Krishna, who is this? I am seeing this great, beautiful. He is your beauty and my beauty combined. You know, his beauty is double beauty. You have 64 qualities and I have 24 qualities. And he is combined, you know, all these qualities. It becomes 64 plus 25 becomes 89 qualities. You know, I mean, he has the mood and complexion. And who is this beautiful form? I am feeling enchanted. But Krishna, I am not able to understand whether this personality is me. Sometimes I feel that he is me. And sometimes I feel that he is you. So I am getting confused. Who is he? So then Krishna says, it is you and me combined. We will combine together as ekatmano bhibhui puradeya phedo katauto. We have become two for the sake of Leela in Vrindavan. We'll again become one for again sake of Leela in Navadvip and Puri. We will combine. I will take up your mood and complexion, golden complexion, to relish the Mahabhav which you are feeling for me. So my dear Radha, and my name will be Gauranga. Gauranga will be my very confidential name. Gauranga will include your bhav, my bhav, everything. Gauranga will include all the Vraja bhav, Navadvip bhav, Puri bhav, all the, even Radharani became attracted to this Gauranga Rupa, Gauranga Naam, Gauranga Dham. So the third point is the direct order of Nityanand Prabhu is to chant Gauranga Naam. He told all living entities that Bhaja Gauranga, Kaha Gauranga, Laha Gauranga Naam. Even Bhakti Rakshak Sridhar Maharaj, you know, my Gurudev's godbrother, he said that about Nityanand Prabhu. He was ordered to preach the name of Krishna, but instead he began to preach the name of Gauranga. In the next page, he says, for our own welfare, we bow down to Nityanand Prabhu with our humility, because he preached the name of Gauranga. He is the Acharya, the Gauranga Naam. There is sometimes people don't accept Bhaja Gauranga, Kaha Gauranga. They think which scripture this is mentioned. But that verse is again mentioned in Chaitanya Charitamrita, same verse 1.29. It says, Chaitanya Seva, Chaitanya Gao, Lao Chaitanya Naam, Chaitanya Jai Bhakti Kare, Shai Mura Prana. Again, Nityananda Prabhu is saying the same thing in Chaitanya Charitamrita. So, in fact, he is saying that, Kashta Nahi, Veya Nahi, Na Pabe Jata Na, Sri Gauranga Boli Nache Nahi Ka Bhavana. If you chant Gauranga's name and dance, there will be no kashta and there will be no suffering. All the offenses will be finished forever. And then he writes, Bhaktivinod Thakur, he writes in the Bodo Sukher Khobar Gai song, he says, Ek bar dekhle chakhe jal, ek bar dekhle chakhe jal, Gaur bole nitai den sakal sambal. एक बार नित्यानंद प्रभु ने आंख में आंसू देख लिए आपके कि गौरांग बोल के आप रोए एक बार तो नित्यानंद प्रभु आपको कभी नहीं छोड़ेंगे. नित्यानंद प्रभु विल नेवर लीव यू इफ वंस ही सीज द आई टियर इन योर आईज बाय चैंटिंग गौरांग गौरांग. इवन वंस इफ यू क्राई इन लव. And the fourth point is mentioned here is Narottam Das Thakur, the great Acharya, who is considered 1/16th Avesh avatar of Gauranga. Narottam Das Thakur and Srinivas Acharya and Shamanand Prabhu, these three were the trinity. Three of them were the pillars of devotion after Gauranga disappeared after 100 years. They were the greatest Acharyas of their times. So Narottam Das Thakur, Srinivas Acharya is considered an avesh of Gauranga and Narottam Das is considered the avesh of Nityananda Prabhu's Kripa and Advaita Acharya's Kripa, the avesh Shamananda Prabhu. So Narottam Das Thakur actually describes in his famous song which Srila Prabhupada liked very much. Says, Je Gaurangir Naam Loe Tar Hoy Premodaye Tar Mui Jai Boli Hari. Says, anyone who chants the name of Gauranga, Krishna Prem will manifest in his body. Prem Udaye Tar Hoy Premodaye. And Narottam is going to this extent, even though he is Mahabhagavat, Paramhamsa, but he is saying, I will become a slave of that person who is chanting Gauranga. Taramui jai balihari. Means I will give my life. Main uska naukar ban jaunga. Jo Gauranga ka naam leke jiska sharir mein prem paida ho raha hai. He is willing to give his fully. Balihari. Balihari means surrender. Apne aap ko bali chadana chahte hai. Bali. So, that is the glories of Gauranga Naam. It gives instant prem. Then Narottam Das Thakur writes in the same song, Griheva banete thake, ha Gauranga bole dake, Narottam mage tara sanga. Then Narottam says, I want the association of that devotee who stays in Grihastha or Sannyasi, who is constantly chanting Gauranga. Gauranga! 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 I want constantly his association. You know, Narottam Das Thakur is a king. His association. So, humko to aur bhi utsuk hona chahiye. We should anchor so much. And then he is saying, what is the qualification to chant Harinam? Harinam qualification is described in this song. Gauranga bolite hobe pulaka sharir, hari hari bolite nayane babe neer. In the beginning, when by chanting Gauranga's naam, when the body will become pulakit, romanchit, because hari naam lene se direct pulakit nahi hoga sharir, kyunki hamara aparad ki badha aati hai. Because of our offenses, by chanting hari naam, Hare Krishna Mahamantra, we will not immediately feel the full ecstasy of hari naam. Because our offenses are covering like a cloud the full mercy of Harinam. Harinam and Gauranam, they have the same Shakti, but the difference is in the Harinam, the clouds, our anarthas is covering the Shakti, whereas in Gauranam, the Lord is not considering this avatar, no offense. So, by chanting Gauranam, we will get become free. Pulakita sharir, the body will become exhilarated in joy, and then when we chant Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare, then nayanai babe neer, then tears will come in our eyes. Actually, the real effect, result of chanting Hari Nam is that we have to cry. Tears of prem should come from the eyes, otherwise our heart is hard like a stone. So that is the fourth reason why we should chant the name of Gauranga. Fifth reason is, this is the verse which has actually, it is actually the deepest secret of Kali Yuga. This shloka in Navadvipa Mahatmya, this shloka was hidden very deep. In the book of Bhaktivinoda Thakur in Navadvipa Mahatmya. And probably because the original Bengali edition of Navadvipa Mahatmya was not available everywhere. It was only available in Navadvipa. So, when I received, because I read this commentary of Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada in Chaitanya Charitamrita saying that Gauranga Mantra is on the same level as Radha Krishna. But I wanted more pramana and more description of the glories of Gauranga Naam. So I was researching, and then I, most by great fortune, I found the Bengali book of Navadvipa Mahatmya. And then when I read the first chapter, the whole secret was revealed. Actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is the Gauranga Mantra Acharya, you know, because he has revealed the whole secret of Gauranga Naam Tattva in Navadvipa Mahatmya. He writes, we will discuss that in detail in the later part, but the essential verse there is that he says, Kali jivera aparadha asankhya durvar, Gaura nama vinatara nahika uddhar. You know Hindi, you can understand that Kali jive aparadha, Kaliyug ke jivon ka aparadha asankhya aur durvar hai. The offenses of Kaliyuga souls are unlimited and insurmountable, formidable. Nobody can stop offenses from our own effort. Nobody can. It is constantly attacking us. Because of Kaliyuga, we see faults, we have such a critical mentality, and we keep on committing offense. We kill so many animals while walking, and so many offenses are committed. So asankhya durvar. That is why Bhaktivinoda Thakur says the only way is Gaura Nama Vinatara Nahi Kauta. Without Gauranga's name, there is no deliverance for the people of Kali Yuga. Because without Gauranga Nam, people will not even get qualification to chant Hari Nam. That Prabhupada mercifully gave us the Panchatattva Mantra, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda, Sri Advaita Gadadha, Sri Vasadi Gaura. Because he said at least people can chant Gaura Nam in the form of Panchatattva Mantra, they get offenses will be less. But Prabhupada said that Panchatattva Mantra cannot be chanted separately on beads, because that mantra is not given in the scriptures anywhere, not chanted by any acharya, like mala, 108 times. But Gauranga Mantra is Gauranam, and it has been recommended. Prabhupada specifically described not Gauranga and Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Shivananda Sen, all our acharyas. If Shivananda Sen actually chanted the Gaur Gopal mantra, Ishta mantra, then he must have received Diksha also from in that mantra. Ishta mantra is one which received secretly from Gurudev. That is known as Ishta mantra. So, it is not described that who was the guru of Shivananda Sen in the Gauranga mantra. But it must be either Nityananda Prabhu or Advaita Acharya who must have, or Gauranga himself who must have given him Gauranam. So Gauranga mantra has been passed down in our parampara also. Our acharyas have chanted along with the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur writes that Ataiva Gauravina Kalite Upahai ना देखी को थाए आरो शास्त्र पुकाराए, कि गौर के बिना कलयुग में कोई उपाय नहीं है. शास्त्र बार बार बता रहे हैं गौरांग, विदाउट गौरांग देर इज नो मीन्स इन कलयुगा. स्क्रिप्चर इज सेइंग, एंड द सिक्स्थ पॉइंट इज दैट पार्वती वंस शी सॉ शिवा डांसिंग वेरी मैडली. शिवा स्टार्टेड डांसिंग वेरी madly, chanting Gauranga, 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 Gauranga. He was chanting in very much bhav, very, very forcefully. And Parvati said, Shankara, I have never seen you in so much bhav. This is even greater than Tandava. I mean, this dancing, you are so much ecstasy. Please tell me the secret. Why are you dancing so much? How can I get the same prem which you are experiencing now? Please tell me the secret. So at that time, Shankara gave Diksha to Parvati in Gauranga Nam. And Shankara said, Gauri Saha Shiva Gauranga Nam, Gaiya Gaiya Purah Kam. Then Parvati started chanting Gauranga with Shankara ji, and both of their innermost desires were fulfilled by chanting Gauranga Nam. This is in Navadvip Dham Mahatmya. Then after giving Diksha Parvati, telling her about the glories of Gauranga Nam, Shankarji told Parvati about the bhajan, Gauranga bhajan, how it is done. Shankarji said, Gauranga bhajano saralati sahajatahara falavitati. Gauranga bhajan is very, very easy to do. Sarala. You see that verse? It is there. बीबी नंबर गौरांग भजन सरल अति सहजता फल विदति वेरी क्विकली वन गेट्स द फ्रूट ऑफ गौरांग नाम भजन एंड द सरल अति इज वेरी इजी टू परफॉर्म ऑल्सो वन कैन इवन चैंट विद ऑफेंसेस एंड द लॉर्ड विल नॉट कंसिडर And then Shiva says, Gauranga boliya krandan kore, Gauranga darshan paya satavare. If somebody chants Gauranga name and is crying, then Gauranga's darshan will be very quickly attained. Satavare, very easy to attain Gauranga darshan. Aur ek bar Gauranga ka darshan mil gaya to Radha Krishna to mutti mein. गौरांग तो राधा कृष्ण वो प्रकट हो जाएंगे जैसे रामानंद राय के सामने हो गए ये सोर्ड इज फॉर्म ऑफ राधा कृष्ण ही सोर्ड द होल ब्रज टू रामानंद राय सिमिलरली इफ यू सी गौरांग देन राधा कृष्ण इज ऑलरेडी अटेंड इन फैक्ट इट इज सेड बाय सर्वम भट्टाचार्य दैट इफ 100 लाइव्स वन वर्शिप्स राधा कृष्ण देन वन कैन अंडरस्टैंड गौरांग So he is the confidential form of Radha Krishna. Vindata Vishayostasya Bhakti Chata Janmani. If people have, devotees have bhakti for Vrindavan, Radha Krishna for one Chata Janmani, 100 lives, then one will come to Gauranga Bhaja. So, I mean, but on the same hand, Gauranga Bhajan is very easy to perform. And Ananda Samhita, Lord Shiva again tells Parvati that Dharayami Urdu Vadane Deveshi Samhitam Imam Mantram Cha Gaur Chandrasya Namedam Sarva Mangalam. Oh my dear Parvati, I am holding these two things always with me. One is Ananda Samhita, this book, and all Gauranga Mantra of Gauranga is always going on in my heart. Sarva Mangalam, it is the Namatmaka. Gauranga naam is sarva mangalam and it's always in my heart. Then point 7 is in Abhijitha Mahatmya chapter 7 and the king Suvarna Sen who was very attached to materialistic life. Narada came to deliver him in Suvarna Bihar. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati established beautiful temple there. You have seen that. Suvarna Bihar Gaudiya Math, the original stones, Suvarna Sen's kingdom, 25 lakh years ago, still there. Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati had a vision when he was walking past that land. He said, I want to buy that land.
And he spent 25 lakh rupees in those days.
No, he did not spend. He said, I want to buy that land. So, the disciples did not understand because that was totally jungle, cobras, tigers, and all these things were staying in that land. He was walking from Narsingapalli to Godrum, like that way this Suvarna Bihar comes. So, but he told his disciples, you go and approach the owner and tell him you want to buy. So owner said, why does Prabhupada Maharaj want this land? I will give him nice cultivated land, he can cultivate things. Ye to jungle hai, why does he want this land? And Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati said, no, I want quickly this land only. And then the transaction was done, the land was purchased. Then Bhaktisiddhanta Prabhupada sent all his brahmachari disciples, said, now you search that land very carefully. And they were searching the whole land and they found a big cobra. It was guarding the ruins of the palace of Suvarna Sen. They were from Satyayuga's time. And very ancient time. And then everybody was surprised all these things coming out and they asked Prabhupada, what is it? Bhaktisiddhanta Prabhupada said, this is the Suvarna Sen's kingdom. He is a great devotee. He appeared in Gaurlila as Buddhimanta Khan, who did the marriage, who sponsored the marriage of Gauranga and Vishnupriya, second marriage. And he gave the costumes for Leela of Chandrasekhar Acharya's, the natakas, dramas. He used to give costumes, sponsor. He's rich man. So, Suvarna Sen Raja, he was very materialistic. When he was old also, he was trying to conquer all the around territories. He wanted more land, more land, more land. So Narada became Dayamaya, saying this foolish king is staying in Navadvip, and instead of asking for prema and bhakti, he is asking for more land. So Narada Muni came down and he told Raja, he gave Upadesh on Vairagya, and they told Raja that Kali, Pragate, Gaurahari is coming to come in the very land you are the king. You are in Satya Yuga now, but you are very very fortunate that the Lord is going to come in your own kingdom, your own home. Why don't you chant Gauranga's name and you worship him and you will attain him, the goal of your life. And Narada became so ecstatic in singing the names of Gauranga that his Veena started shivering and he was so much ecstasy he left. Then before he left, Suvarnasen asked Narada, what is the secret? How can I get this prem very quickly? Then Narada Muni said, Jai Gaura Nama Labe Tate Krishna Kripa Habe Vrajevasyate Paibe. One who chants Gaura Nam, Krishna will be merciful. Because ye Gauranga ka roop hai, ye Krishna ka sabse ghooya roop hai. Krishna ye roop ko chupa ke rakhte hai. Krishna keeps hide this form because it is there to relish internal bhav of Radharani. So it is most confidential form. तो जब इस ये रूप का नाम लेते हैं हम तो डायरेक्ट भगवान के हृदय तक पहुंच सकते हैं क्योंकि ये रूप में भगवान खुद अपनी इच्छाओं को पूरी करते हैं. He is relishing his own internal desires to know what is Radha's love for him, the glories of Radha's love, how Radha relishes his beauty and how much happiness Radha feels in his seva. Three desires. Radha Rani's three desires which Krishna wants to understand. That is why he takes the Gauranga form and he comes to Puri. These three desires were fulfilled in Gambira, in Puri. These three desires he is hankering in Vrindavan, they are not fulfilled. But in Puri he is fulfilled. He has experienced that Vipralambha Bhav. And he fulfilled these three desires. And he relished highest. That is why Gambira is not different from Vrindavan. Puri is actually Gupta Vrindavan. In Puri there are two Vrindavans. One is Tota Gopinath, Yameshwar, Vamshivata, and one is Sundara Chalgundicha, which is a Vrindavan for Jagannath. Then this Vrindavan is for Gauranga. So when Gopakumar had come in Puri, then he went to darshan of Jagannath and he was missing Vrindavan. Then Jagannath revealed to him that the whole of Puri became Vrindavan. The ocean became Jamuna. And the sand dunes became Govardhan, the Nilachal hill below the temple became Govardhan. And the Sundarachal Gundicha became the Jagannath Vallabh Gardens became the forests of Vrindavan. And he could see the whole of Vraj in Puri. Actually Puri is not different than Vraj, but it is very Gupta. That is why Lord Krishna says to Shiva in the Padma Purana, E Puri ra marma mora keha nahi jane. पुरी का मर्म मोर कहना ही जाए. पुरी का यू नो द नोबडी नोज द कॉन्फिडेंशियल सीक्रेट ऑफ जगन्नाथ पुरी. इवन भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती स्पेंड इज लास्ट डेज हियर इन उस भजन कुटीर जस्ट नेक्स्ट टू तोटा गोपीनाथ टेम्पल एंड चतक पर्वत गोवर्धन दैट इज वृंदावन. सो one can attain Vrindavan by chanting Gauranga Naam. That is what Narada Muni is telling Suvarna Sen. And then Narada Muni is making the final conclusive statement to Suvarna Sen. He is saying, Gaura Naam Nalaya Je Krishna Bhaje Gya Shri Krishna Bahu Gale Paya. If somebody is not chanting Gaura Naam and if somebody worships Krishna, he will achieve Krishna after very long time. Narada Muni is saying, not I am saying. One will attain Krishna after a very long time. But on the other hand, he is saying, Gauranga Naam Laiji Satya Krishna Ho Paise Aparad Nahi Rahetaya. Gauranga Naam Laiji. But anybody who chants Gaura Naam, very quickly he will attain Krishna. And Aparad Nahi Rahetaya. And no offenses will remain in his heart, you know, automatically he will get that love of Krishna very, very soon. So it is a positive as well as negative injunction. If you chant Gauranga's name, you get Krishna very quickly. If you don't chant, you don't get it. So it is very sealed, you know, there is no chance to really have any your own interpretation. To make your own, anybody can make their own interpretation. It is very, very clear that Narada Muni has instructed this to Suvarna Sen. And in the point number 8, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writes that actually Vrajanath asked this question to Babaji. He says that Sri Gauranga yadi sakshat paripurna tattva hoilan tabe tahar pujara vyavastha ki? In chapter 14, he writes that if Gauranga is sakshat parabrahma, Krishna himself, then he should have his own mode of worship and his own mode of mantras. Like, you know, Narsingh Dev ka alag mantra hai, Ram ke alag mantra hai, alag puja hai. To Gauranga to sakshat Radha Krishna hai, unka bhi mantra hona chahiye, unka bhi puja ka vidhi hona chahiye. That Gauranga is the self, the Lord, supremely independent Lord. So he should have his own mantras, his own worship of, through his name. So he asked the question, what is that? So Babaji is replying, the Paramahansa Babaji, he used to chant 2 lakh names daily. So Paramahansa, Siddha Purush, he is replying that Gauranga Nama Mantre Gaura Puja Karilehu Yaha Hoye, Krishna Nama Mantre Krishna Puja Karilehu Tahe Hoye. Krishna Mantre Gaura Puja Va Gaura Mantre Krishna Puja Sakalei Ek. Ihate Je Bheda Buddhi Karesh Nitant Anabhigya Au Kalira Das. Very clear. He is saying that Gaura Puja in Kali Yuga can be done by chanting Gauranga's name, because Naam is everything in Kali Yuga. Puja karne ka kisi ke paas yogyata nahi. 64 seva aparad ho jate. 64 seva aparad. So the only way to worship Gauranga in Kali Yuga is the name, Gauranga's name. So by chanting Gauranga Naam Mantra, is very clear. Again, Gauranga Naam Mantra is mentioned in Jaiva Dharma. By chanting Gauranga Naam Mantra, Gaura Puja is done in Kali Yuga. And by chanting Krishna Nama Mantra, which is Hare Krishna Mantra, Krishna Puja is done. But because Gaura and Krishna are the same person, that is by chanting Krishna Mantra, you can do Gaura Puja. And by chanting Gaura Mantra, actually you are doing Krishna Puja. There's no difference. Because both are the same personality. So somebody may say, by chanting Hari Nam, I am doing Gaura Puja. So why do I need to chant Gauranam, extra, Gauranga name? But we will see in the later verses that even though Gauranga's name and Krishna's name are the name of the same personality, with respect to the sadhaka, with respect to the chanter, there is the effect is different. It is more easier in Gauranam. So Vrajanath is saying, Channa avatare mantra ki rupa hua jaye. So, Vrajanath is saying, Babaji, but how will I find these mantras of the Channa avatar, Gauranga? Did you find that?
Yes, sir.
Channa avatar eva mantra ki rupa pavva jaye. So, and Babaji is saying here that those who make difference between Gauranam and Krishna Nam and Gaura Puja and Krishna Puja, and Gaura Dham and Krishna Dham, those who don't have equal affection to both of them, they are very unfortunate, because they are the same personality, they are making a difference. Like, you know, if you accept Krishna and if you don't accept Ram avatar, what will happen?
Committing offense.
Offense. It is accepting half the hen. Adi murgi ko le liye. Kaat ke piche ke sone ka anda de. So it is an offense against the Vishnu Tattva if we don't accept all the incarnations of. So if we accept Krishna, but if we don't have the same faith in Gauranga, then our Krishna Naam will never bear the fruit, because we are not accepting Krishna Tattva fully. Gauranga is also Krishna Tattva. Krishna has become in the mood of Radha. So we are not making progress. So that why we are not making progress, because we are not giving equal emphasis to Gauranam, Gauradham, Gauralila, Krishna Dham, Krishna Leela, Krishna, both should be given equal respect and worship. We are chanting 25,000 names of Hare, Hare Krishna mantra, Krishna Naam daily, 16 malas at least. But we are chanting Gaur Naam how much? Actually Gaur came for us in Kali Yuga. Krishna came in Dwapar Yuga, he did not even give us entry in the Rasa pastime. But Gaur came, Krishna came again to give us entry, he is more dayalu. But unka naam hum 16 baar bhi nahi lete din mein.
But according to this Babaji Maharaj, he is saying if you chanting Krishna Naam, you automatically worship in Gauranga.
Yes, but if you are chanting Krishna Naam offenselessly. Because Krishna Naam kare aparadhera vichar. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, it is said, Krishna Naam kare aparadhera vichar, aparadhera na hoy vikar. Krishna Naam hum lete hain, to actually Krishna Naam aparadh ke bina, without offenses, taking Krishna Naam is actually directly worshipping Gauranga. There is no difference. When we are chanting offensively, then bahu janme kori adi shravana kirtan tabu Krishna pade nahi paaye prema dhan. Krishnadas Kaviraj is saying, even if one chants Krishna Naam for many lives, but still if one is committing offenses, then that prema will not come. So that is why Krishna Naam, to actually worship Gaura through Krishna Naam, one has to chant the Krishna Naam offenselessly. So to chant offenselessly, there are two ways. Either you chant constantly, 64 rounds. Jo diva raatra naam loy anuttapa kore. One who chants 24 hours naam, then one can come to the level of the aparadhas will flee. Naam aparadha jaye, naam phala dhore. Haridas Thakur says, unless one chants constantly, 16 rounds are not enough. 16 rounds, one will take many lives. 25,000 names of Krishna Naam. Because the offenses are making a big barrier in front of us. And what is happening is, the more Krishna Naam we chant, the more we become implicated in the offense, because there is Naam Aparadha. Before we started chanting the name, we were doing the ordinary mundane sins like, you know, killing animals, eating meat and all these things. But Naam Aparadha is even more dangerous. There is no prayaschit atonement for that. So, Krishna Naam we chant, but if we don't very, very carefully avoid the 10 offenses, then we become implicated. And that is why our ruchi goes away. We chant for a few years and then we still, we don't get any ruchi. There are so many casualties. You know, devotees come, they chant for a few years and they leave. They go away into maya because the ruchi is not there.
But there is no process in any way that has been recommended. ISKCON especially, I don't know.
Yes.
Other places, but in ISKCON.
There is a recommended process by the acharyas that Gauranga Naam is the Gaura Mantra. Gaura Gopal Mantra is the recommended process to... Either there are two ways to destroy offense. Either you chant constantly Hari Naam, which may not be possible in Kali Yuga for 99.9% of the people. Even 16 rounds we feel difficult to chant. Our mind is not focused. In fact, Hari Naam Chintamani, Haridas Thakur is saying, Krame krame ami laksha naam koribe. Even if I complete laksha naam, still I don't have a drop of bindu of rasa in my heart. My heart is still dry. If the offenses are so strong that even if I chant 64 rounds, still my heart remains dry. You know, have you thought about what is this reason for this?
Well, that's the I left, you know, because if you're making the sweet rice and you're having all the ingredients, and your sweet rice should completely very nice.
Yeah.
But the sweet rice is not coming properly.
Coming.
This the is rice the... has been not cooked. Or
exactly.
Milk has spoiled, or
yes,
something has gone wrong.
Yes, this is the biggest secret of Kali Yuga. This question should be asked by every devotee who is chanting Krishna Naam.
Because after 28 years,
yeah,
I'm not even the same place, but even gone more down.
Yes, yes. So that is that secret question. Is the answer to that question is actually
You can go to point number 22. Since you have raised this question, we will discuss point 22 and why do common people not get Krishna prem? Even though the glories of Krishna Naam and Dham are described in all the scriptures, and this is the secret of secrets which has bewildered the souls and never think about it. And this secret has been finally answered by Bhaktivinoda Thakur in Navadvip Dham Mahatmya. He says, "Ar ek guda katha suna sarvajan. Kali jive yogya vastu gaur lila dhan." He says that, my dear people of Kali Yuga, please hear me, that the most confidential secret of Kali Yuga is Gauranga, is lila dhanam. It is the most important secret. Why? Next line he explains, Krishna nama Krishna dham mahatmya apar, शास्त्र द्वारा जाने सकल संसार। कृष्ण नाम एंड कृष्ण धाम एवरीबडी नोस द ग्लोरीज थ्रू द स्क्रिप्चर्स थ्रू बाय प्रैक्टिसिंग कृष्ण नाम एवरीबडी नोज अबाउट कृष्ण एंड आई मीन पीपल आर प्रैक्टिसिंग कृष्ण भक्ति बट देयर इज अ प्रॉब्लम इन द वर्स 3 इट इज एक्सप्लेन तबु कृष्ण प्रेम साधारण नहीं पाए इहार कारण तुमी चिंता हियाए. Still the common people or the devotees are not getting Krishna prem. Even after worshipping Krishna and chanting his name for many lives. In fact, if you go back to verse 9 point, you can keep that page. In the chapter 10 of Navadvip Dham Mahatmya, Pushkara Raj, Pushkara Tirtha, in North India there is Pushkara. So Pushkara Tirtha appeared in Navadvip. There was one Brahmana, he was a great devotee of Pushkara. He wanted to go to Pushkara, but he was very old. So Pushkara appeared to him in Navadvip. And he told the Brahmana, "Oh my dear Brahmana, I always myself stay in Navadvip." And Pushkara told that Brahmana how to do bhajan in Kali Yuga. He said, "Koti koti varshe kari Krishna bhajan, tathapi namete rati napaye durjan." Even if you chant Krishna naam for koti koti varsha, you may not get namete rati if you are durjan, if your bhajan is committing offense. That's naam aparadh. Koti koti varsha. 1 crore varsha is how much?
Yes.
No, 10 million is 1 crore. 10 million. So, koti means tens of hundreds of millions of years one may do Krishna Naam. But tathap tabu namete rati. So, one will not get attraction for Naam Rati, Pai Durjan. So, in that case, what one should do? Pushkar Dev tells, Gauranga bhajile dushta bhava dure jai. Svalpadine vrajadham radha krishna pai. But if one chants Gauranga's name and one does Gauranga bhajan, then chamatkar ho jata hai. What happens to chamatkar? Svalpadine. Very few days, one will get vrajadham and radha krishna. See this, what pulse is there in this. It's not my saying, it is given in the scripture. Pushkar Raj is saying these words. And you see the contrast. By doing only Krishna bhajan, it is koti varsha. And by doing Gauranga naam bhajan, it is svalpa dina.
So I have not lost so much yet, only 28 years.
Yes, not much. But Gauranga bhajan you do, then it will be only dina. Very few days you will see Radha Krishna. And Rajadham. Very easy, Gauranga is very dayalu. In fact, the direct effect of Gauranga Naam, some people may say that Gauranga Naam will only take us to Navadvip, it will not take us to Vraj.
Radha Krishna. To answer that question, Pushkar Raj speaks the third verse. He says, Nija Siddha Deha Paaye Sakhir Ashraye Nija Kunja Paaye Shri Yugala Sevahaye. By chanting Gauranga Naam, by doing Gauranga Bhajan, one will get one Siddha Deha. Siddha Deha means nowadays people are running after Siddha Deha. Anybody who can show them Siddha Deha, they easily, everything wanted cheaply. Without the Anvatha Nivruti. But actually, if one wants Siddha Deha very quickly, then the secret is already there. Gauranga Naam Bhajan. Siddha Deha cannot be got by artificial means, by thinking about one Siddha Deha. Oh, I am a gopi in Krishna Leela, or I am a cow. Some people start, doing that, thinking like that. But artificially thinking, one will, the Siddha Deha, because our Jada Deha is still there. We are thinking with the Jada Mana, Jada Buddhi, Jada Ahankar. How can we think about Siddha Deha? So the only way for Jada and the Jada stage to get our Siddha Deha very quickly is Gauranga Naam Bhajan. Gauranga Bhajan. And we will give Siddha Deha, we will get the shelter of the Sakhis. Then we will get our own Kunja in the Nitya Leela of the Lord. And then we will do direct Yugala Seva. Four things we will get by doing Gauranga Bhajan. This Pushkar Dev is telling.
But Maharaj, in ISKCON, there is nobody who has given the Gauranga Naam to any person. Is it true, right?
Yes. Everyone, we are chanting Panchatattva Mantra, that is also good. That is also nice, one is making it much more. The different devotees have different understanding of the scriptures. So everyone is free. Those who are worshipping Ghor Nithai deities, chanting the Panchatattva Mantra and Ghor Nithai Kirtan. So that also one will get benefit. But my preaching is I directly stress the chanting of Gauranga Mantra. Gauranam, because it is...
But you do, you recommend on the mala?
Or? Yes.
No, the Hare Krishna mantra.
No, Hare Krishna mantra cannot be
given.
That is the order of Gauranga. Hare Krishna mantra should be chanted 1 lakh times, 64 rounds. That order cannot be given. But I recommend that before every mala of Hare Krishna, one mala of Gauranga should be chanted. Every mala of Hare Krishna, which we chant, one round of Gauranga. Gauranga, Gauranga, Gauranga.
Every mala.
Yes, 108 times at least. If we are chanting 25,000 times Krishna's name, we should chant at least 5,000 times Gauranga's name. Because Prabhupada said in one commentary that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's name is more essential than the chanting of Hare Krishna. Did you read that?
No, I said I never read so much books, but it's a revealing by yours, Satan. But he never gave particularly like what you're saying, that at least you chant the one round, one Hare Krishna Mahamantra, then one.
Because Panchatattva Mantra Prabhupada allowed us to chant only 3 times.
Did you have any your research somewhere where the Prabhupada saying that the Gauranga name is more essential?
Yes.
Krishna Keshav Krishna Keshav Krishna Keshav Pahi Mam Rama Raghav Rama Raghav Rakshamam
Krishna Keshav Krishna Keshav Krishna Keshav Pahi Mam Rama Raghav Rama Raghav Rama Raghav Rakshamam
Krishna 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 Pahi Mam Rama Raghav Rama Raghav Rama